So here's a quick run through of my audio setup, guys. I'm going to go through each component one by one, each separate. It mainly comprises of TIAC with some Sony and majority as well, and then the odd Panasonic. So what I'll do is go through each one by one, giving you the model numbers and its spec and what it actually does. So this is the majority. It's a networker as well as many other things. It's connected with the Cambridge audio side of things, and it's available on Amazon at around 99 English pound. If I switch it on, it's connected to the internet, and we've gone straight to Spotify, which is also connected to my phone. But I'll run through the other features first, then you can see all what it can do. So we've got a music player, which allows you to connect your USB into there. We've also got a DAB radio, which will give you your digital audio broadcast. Then we've got FM radio for the box standard, for those who can't receive a digital network radio. We have Bluetooth audio, which is worth its weight in gold, so you can connect your mobile phone to it. Auxiliary in, so you can connect a device to it. And internet radio, which is one of my favourites. There's over 2,500 to date broadcasts coming through the internet radio, and plus probably many more. And I use that mainly for my podcasts to listen to. Going back to Spotify, what we can do is get our mobile phone. Let's just come back here. So there's Spotify on my mobile, and we'll hit the play button. And if I then connect that to the majority, and probably turn the volume up now, let's have a look. I think we're still on pause. Let's try again. Right, there we go. This is royalty free music, so I won't hit a copyright. And that's Spotify through my phone onto the majority, and then coming through on the speakers. So what we have here is the TIAC AD850. It's cassette, CD and USB. Just normal features on the cassette itself. One directional playback. Your fast forward and rewind. We have a counter reset. We have the CD player. And one of the really good features on it is the USB, because that allows us to record from line in to USB, from tape to USB, CD to USB, or we can also do tape and CD together. So it's showing, I think, a couple of folders on there. But if we wanted to record something from Line In, i.e. Spotify, and there's an album we're looking for and we can't get anymore, then what we would do is hit Line In. We'll hit USB. It's just calculating the bit rate and preparing the USB stick. You can see the volume meter going up and down, so we can turn the volume right down on the record level or right up for the recording. And then if we hit USB again, it's now recording. If you can see there, Line In, record and play. And then obviously at the end of the recording we would stop. And if you were to hit record again, it would just continue that file process straight after the last one. So what I'm going to do now is go to USB and then we'll move it onto the playback, just allow it to read the USB stick. And we'll hit play it. And we can move. And there's that last track we recorded.
Like a never fading whisper in the breeze. Oh, we will keep on changing.
So if there was a super rare album you were after and you couldn't get it, then obviously Spotify may have it as a playlist. You can record that directly on USB or tape. And as you know, playback with this is anything from the car to your hi-fi or your PC. Just make sure I don't get a copyright hit. So that is the TIAC CD, USB and audio cassette. So this is the TIAC double cassette dual record W1200. Like I said, double cassette dual record, which allows you not only to record on each deck but simultaneously on both decks at the same time by hitting parallel record. Again, it's also connected to the networker, so whatever's being played through the network you can record directly onto audio cassette tape. It's on pause there, ready to record. And it's now recording that. Let's see if we can see that. Can you see that? So there's your noise bars telling you how much your levels are at, and we can control that. It's also got a pitch control level, but that's only on tape deck A. It's got your usual counter resets, auto dub start. Doesn't have Dolby Pro Logic on it, I, B or C, but it has a noise reduction function which kind of gives you that effect. And again, we can record directly onto cassette tape, either tape to tape or Line In from a digital source. And this is the TIAC integrated stereo amp, which is known as the AR650 Mark II. Multi-room speakers, so you can have your speakers playing in a separate location. Auxiliary 1 and 2, tape and CD record. Tuner, phono and CD. Has a mic level, so you can do your audio dubbing verbally. Loudness on and off. And it is integrated with the next CD player I'm going to show you. Both connect together with a remote. So we're now looking at the TIAC CD USB iPod. This is the compact disc player CD P650. This is the remote connected to the amp, so I can control this unit off the amp's remote control. Does your CD text, playback from USB. It has a level control as well for your recording, and you can record from CD straight to USB or line in to USB as well. So this is the second in the range of the TIAC double cassette deck with dual record. The feature on this one is it's auto reverse as well. The model number is the W890R Mark II. And like I say, on both decks you have the auto reverse on it. It has phono and mic connection, mic level control, pitch control, as well as your box standard return to zero, EMS, dual record, and a multi-function on your reverse mode as well. And this is the TIAC compact disc recorder. The model number is a CDRW 890 Mark II. And this will allow you to record directly onto a CDR, CDRW, whether it's a music CD or just your over the shelf normal CDR. You can also record line in from an optical source or phono analog, and it's programmable, has the erase feature, finalize feature, and a sync all, where as you press the source it'll automatically sync. And that is just a box standard CDR, nothing special. So this is the Sony mini disc player. The model number is the MDS JE440. It does the 2x long play, either long play 2 or long play 4. And this is integrated with the dual cassette tape recorder, which I'm going to show you next. And this is the Sony double cassette recorder, model number TCWE675. It's dual record again, like the two TIACs. It also has the auto reverse feature on both decks, automatic music search, along with pitch control, directional playback modes, the record level finder, and the auto sync as well. Put no cassettes in it. And this is synced up with the Sony mini disc player as well.
Oh,
So I have to be careful I don't hit a copyright. So we'll do the automatic music search for the next track. And it'll also do auto reverse as well. Out of the two TX, I would say this is the better high performance model with more features on. And the amp I'm using to power both Sony tape deck and mini disc player is the Yamaha 2071, which also has 4K pass through for the TV, as well as a lot of inputs, 1 to 5 on the audio and 4 HDMI ports on the back as well, allowing me to connect anything from a game console to TVs for playback. So if you're going to ask why have I got a MIDI hi-fi, then I bought this solely based on the sound performance alone. The speakers are bi-amped, twin wired, so the sound is phenomenal. It does have a 5-disc CD changer along with auto reverse cassette deck, tuner and auxiliary in. I was going to use it in a separate location within the home, but up to now it's sat there underneath the TV and the sound on it is phenomenal. Unfortunately, I can't do the playback because I've got no copyright material on CD or cassette. It is in exceptionally good condition considering it's probably almost 20 year old, no marks and scars, fully tested, and like I say, the sound on it is second to none. It is. So this is my setup, guys. The Sony TV, the Panasonic MIDI audio hi-fi, the TIAC and the Sony, and I'm running a set of Panasonic speakers which are bi-amped, the Yamaha speakers and a set of Wharfdales as well.